Now, another subject, winemaking. And winemaking in Britain is not confined to dads with ready-made kits from the local chemist who commandeer the bathroom or the garage. Hundreds of years ago, the Romans made wine in Britain. And now, believe it or not, working vineyards are having a comeback. And that's despite positive discrimination against them by the taxman and the weather.
No, I'm not standing in the middle of France enjoying the grape harvest. I am, in fact, just 40 miles from London, in the Thames Valley, in one of the 150 English vineyards. Of course, our production of wine is still tiny compared with that of the continent, but with over 400 acres of vines in England, we do now come within the common market's definition of a serious wine-producing country, and that means at least 2,000 bottles per acre. The farmer at Westbury near Reading is Bernard Theobald. He'd been in general farming for 30 years, but he's unusual in that he's also been experimenting with wine for the last four. Mr. Theobald, what was your original investment in wine?
Approximately £1,000 an acre, spread over 3 years for the vineyard itself.
And how long does it take you to start to get a return on that investment?
A minimum of 3 years. You might get a little in the third year if it's been three good growing years. Fourth, fifth year, you really start to come into the money.
How does your investment compare with, say, beef farming?
In terms of the actual money invested, probably about the same as beef enterprise, but of course the return and the profit on it is enormously different. If you get perhaps £10-15 an acre profit, net profit from beef, you're probably doing very well. Whereas I'm expecting, when the vineyard is mature, on average, good years and bad years, to have not less than £1,000 an acre net profit.
What about methods? I mean, France has been growing wine for hundreds of years. Are we very primitive by comparison?
I wouldn't think we're at all primitive. Most growers have followed pretty traditional methods of France and Germany, in particular the double Goyot method of training and pruning, and I've gone to look at the New World methods. This is the Geneva Double Curtain. The advantages of it are that the capital investment is about one-fifth. We only have 400 vines to the acre instead of 2,000 with the Goya method. We're standing upright, for example, to pick the things now. You've seen my pickers, and there we are, straight backs, picking easily. The labour requirement in tending the vine is approximately a fifth of the Goya method.
You've just started the grape harvest today. Now, presumably, if it had been raining, you couldn't have done that. Aren't you very much at the mercy of the weather here?
Of course, but all farmers in every occupation, every production from the land, are definitely always at the mercy of the weather. Last year, I was feeding my cattle by July on full winter rations. It cost me a bomb. Of course, we're always at the mercy of the weather. Every farmer is in every country in the world.
So what are the other risks of growing vines in this country?
Well, the weather, of course, bad weather, as we've had this year, the last 3 weeks raining, will produce a lot of mould, rot, botrytis. The fungus diseases are our worst enemies, without any doubt at all, with the vines. Birds, if we didn't protect the vines against the birds, they would take the lot.
We do come within common market regulations as a wine-growing
yes.
country.
Yes.
Why, then, is the duty on homegrown wines so much higher than, say, France or Italy?
Well, one has to realise that, in fact, the duty paid on English wines are identical to the duty paid on imported wines in this country. It is only in France that they don't pay that duty. In this country, you pay, whatever it is, 60-65p a bottle on every bottle of wine, irrespective of where it's come from England or from abroad.
His winemaking machinery is housed in this beautiful Elizabethan barn. What about the capital costs of all this machinery, Mr. Theobald? That must be very high.
It is very high, and, of course, one can shop around. Last year, I was unable to do much shopping around, and these tanks here, which were new last year, they hold 450 gallons each, and they cost £550, new. We were very lucky this year. We found a bankruptcy sale and bought a lot of equipment at an absolute song. I was very, very lucky. It saved me a lot of money.
In the nearest town of Pangbourne, we found Mr. Aldo Rossi, who, after managing international hotels for many years, is now a connoisseur's wine merchant. Mr. Rossi, is the duty on our homegrown wines so high that they really can't be competitive?
Absolutely. It is much too high. About 68 pennies per bottle.
But leaving aside the duty, can the quality of wines like this really justify the price?
No, I don't think so. They are comparatively very expensive as compared to the similar or better quality wines from the continent.
So who buys them?
Oh, all kinds of people, visitors from abroad, Americans, Canadians, French, and English people traveling through Pangbourne, or even having heard of this English wine. Some of them are interested from a wine point of view, others think it's rather fun.
Well, Angela Lambert, generous to a fault, has let me have a bottle of Mr. Theobald's wine. Looks good, smells good. It's not bad at all. I hear even the French are buying English wine. So maybe if the taxman relents, even we might be able to afford it.